Show for you today here at Coweta County Animal Control. My name is Jeanette Higgins and I'm a volunteer with the Noonan Coweta Humane Society, and we have decided to do a Halloween themed show for you today so that we hope that you will enjoy the show and possibly see one of these sweet little fur babies and want to rush on down here and adopt a pet. Now we're going to go right into the show today because we have some real cute puppies that we just could not wait to get on the show and show you today. I'm going to start off here on the side here with this little cutie pie. This little guy is Fred, and of course all these are boys. They're all lab retriever mixes. They're all this gorgeous tan color and just as cute as they possibly can be. So we're starting off with Fred, and then here in the middle we have Tubby, and he has gotten the nickname Tubby because he is a little porker and for sure is probably stealing all the food from his brothers and being a little greedy guy. But who can resist these cute little puppies, guys? They are absolutely adorable. And then on the end we have the third brother in the litter. That is Pete, and little Pete is like a repeat because all these guys look exactly the same. They're all just cute as they can possibly be, and only about a month old. Looks like they were picked up as strays from Dominic Street. No collar, no ID. They are all in A1, which we think that they are A1 kind of puppies for sure. And we just cannot imagine that they'll last very long here at Animal Control. Somebody's gonna see these puppies and absolutely fall in love and wanna take one or two home for sure. So come on down and meet these three cutie pies. They're down here at Animal Control just waiting for you.
Make some biscuits.
And some of our loyal viewers may recognize this cool cat. This is Curtis, and our volunteer Suzanne is having a great time with him and just mentioned that he is making biscuits in her lap, and that is what he definitely does best. He is extremely affectionate, folks, and just a really nice guy, and certainly probably needs a little scratch and post or something to get those claws shaved down a little bit. He can't help himself, though. He's just absolutely in love with being out here with us and just having a good old time. And like I said, being the cool cat that he is. Curtis is one of those kind of cats you can just do anything to, folks. He'll just roll around in your lap and just be so happy and just so sweet. He's just such a good boy. He's even making air biscuits. He is in C3, that's his kitty cat condo number here at Animal Control. And my goodness, Curtis has been here since July, folks. And oh gosh, Halloween is, you know, this week. It's right around the corner. And he has been here way, way too long. And you know, before Thanksgiving gets here, you know, that's coming up soon too. We need to get this guy a new home for the holidays. So if you're interested in Curtis, please do hurry on down here to Animal Control. He is such a wonderful cat. He's so healthy. He keeps his fur really shiny and clean. That definitely shows you that he's healthy. And like I said, he's extremely affectionate. He's very, very nice and very handsome. And just an all-around great cat. So come on down here and meet Curtis. He's down here at Animal Control waiting to be your new best friend. And we have lots of puppy love going on here, folks. I tell you what, this is the place to be today for sure. Off to my right here, we have this cutie pie guy with the nickname Twix. And then his brother over here to my left, this is Snickers. And of course, we are thinking of candy names because these guys are super sweet. And they are lab mixes, and they're marked as pit bulls, folks, but sorry, don't see any pit bull in them. If you know anything about pit bulls, you'll see that these guys don't have the stocky build and the right shape heads and or really shaped anything to be pit bulls. We truly believe they are lab mixes. They're only about 2 or 3 months old, and both in A7, that's their kennel number here at Animal Control. And oh, who can resist puppy kisses? I tell you what, this really is the place to be. You gotta come down here and get these puppies while they're here, folks, because puppies don't last too long at animal control. They get snatched up really quick and adopted really, really fast, and you don't want to wait. So if you're thinking about it, definitely come down here and meet these cutie pies. These guys will steal your heart. They are just so cute. I do want to mention that they were picked up as cruelty cases, folks, and I don't know who could ever be cruel to something this precious and this innocent and this sweet, but unfortunately it does happen in this world. But they are down here now in animal control waiting for their new home, waiting for somebody that will never ever harm them or be mean to them again. And who can be mean to these guys? They are absolutely precious. So come on down and meet Twix and Snickers. And gosh, you could get tooth decay from these guys. And this is Athena. If you have been watching our show for the past several weeks, you will recognize her. And folks, I don't know why this girl is still here. She is very shy, so maybe people are kind of shying away from her as well. When you open up her cage, she does kind of retreat back a little bit. But if you just pick her up, you'll see that she will just purr and purr. And she always has those eyes that big. She really does. She has extremely expressive eyes, but she's a sweetheart. As you can see, she is absolutely loving our volunteer Suzanne here, and Athena's making all the little biscuits and doing all the little movements, letting us know that she's very, very happy and very content being held, and is just a beautiful little kitten. And folks, she is almost 8 months old and has not really grown much, so we think she's going to be a petite little thing. And she really is. She's just precious and sweet and very, very small. Now, Athena is in C11. That's her cat condo number here at Animal Control. And when she first came into Animal Control, she was so scared, but she is doing fabulous now. And she's getting used to being held, and the guys working here have really worked with her to bring her out of her shell. And folks, she really is a spectacular little girl. Look at those little air biscuits. I love it. It looks like she's trying to swim. Although we know cats are afraid of water, so we won't test her on that. But it looks like she's trying to swim. She's just stretching out those little toes and just really enjoying herself. So come on down and meet Athena. I know when you meet this precious little petite girl that you're going to fall in love. Hey guys, this is gonna have to be quick because we have a very excited girl with the nickname S'mores. And she is all lab and all puppy. She's about 7 months old, actually a few months older than that, maybe 9 or 10 months old at this point. But like I said, she is all puppy and is happy. And we were just saying we would much rather see a happy, energetic dog any day than a dog that's depressed and sad. So there's nothing wrong with being happy, S'mores. And she is a smart, smart dog. We just had a treat out and we asked her to sit and she sat so pretty, folks. She is extremely smart and just an all-around good dog. Look at that happy face. There is nothing wrong with that. Now, S'mores here is in B1, that is her kennel number, and my goodness, she has been here since June, so she probably hasn't, since she hasn't been on the adoption floor, she definitely has lots of energy to burn. And you know, lab retrievers are great, great dogs, folks, they're great family dogs, and she is certainly no exception to that. She will make a wonderful, wonderful addition to anybody's family. So come on down and meet S'mores. She is down here just waiting for you, and she'll be more than happy to sit by the campfire with you and make some s'mores. And we have two very handsome boys on the show for you now, folks. I am holding Tundra, and he is completely jet black and just a wonderful guy. He is extremely affectionate, very, very friendly, and is just purring up a storm. And then we have his brother Beamer here that is the gorgeous gray guy. And he is also equally purring up a storm and doing the biscuits in Miss Suzanne's lap. And I tell you what, these two boys are just wonderful. They're brothers, they get along fabulously. They're picked up as the same, you know, of course at the same place. They're both strays from Teasley Trail. No collar, no ID. And when they came into animal control, they were only about 3 months old. So they've been here, I would say a little over a month, so now they're going on about 4 months old. But such nice, nice boys. They're both so handsome and so sweet. And they don't have to be adopted together, but we would love for them to be able to stay together because two kittens growing up together is just a wonderful thing. They keep each other entertained. They keep each other from getting into trouble. They keep each other from playing with your shoes or something that you don't want them to play with because they play with each other. So that it's really wonderful to have them stick together and grow up together. And then if you, you know, if you get a cat and then you want to get another cat later on, you don't always know that they're going to get along. But here you have two that you know get along. They're siblings. They're great cats. They're great guys. And just truly, truly need a home. So if you can get one, that's fine. But we would absolutely love to keep these boys together so that they can continue to grow up together and just be great brothers. They're both in C40. That's their cage number. And as you can see, they do love each other. They're hugging on each other and loving on each other right now, even as we're filming this segment. But just wonderful cats, gorgeous, very nice soft fur, very, very healthy. You can tell when you pet them that they take very good care of themselves. And that means when you see on the outside that they're healthy, that means their insides are healthy as well. Because a sick cat is not going to take good care of itself. And these boys definitely are not sick and very healthy and very clean and just wonderful. Oh my goodness, I just love them. So come on down here and meet Tundra. Oh, I just noticed he has a little white spot on his chest. He has a little white star on his chest. So come on down and meet Tundra and Beamer. I know when you meet these boys, you are just gonna wanna snatch them up and take them on home. And here we have a very energetic girl with the nickname Wags. So I like to say she went from Wags to Witches down here at Animal Control. But she is a Jack Russell mix, believe it or not, Jack Russell Terrier mix. Obviously mixed with something a little larger than a Jack Russell normally is, but just a very sweet girl. She's about 7 months old. She was picked up as a stray from Robinson Street, no collar, no ID. And this precious girl is an A9, that's her kennel number. Now they did test her for heartworms, it came back negative, which is what we love to hear. And if you know anything about Jack Russell Terriers, you know they are extremely hyper. So she definitely has that hyper side of her, plus she's a puppy. So she's gonna be more like the ADD dog or ADHD dog, and she can't help herself. She was just born that way. She's just a very energetic dog, but happy. And that is what we love to see here at Animal Control. We always wanna see a happy dog. So if you're interested in Wags, please do get down here to Animal Control. She's a very precious girl. I love the three-toned look on her ears. She's got the black, brown, and white on her ears in spots, and she's just very, very sweet and very, very cute. So come on down and meet Wags. She's down here at Animal Control just waiting for you to rescue her. We have a gorgeous, gorgeous girl to introduce you to now. This is Hallie. She is a beautiful, she's gonna talk to us. I think she agrees that she's pretty. She's a tortie, which is kind of like the tortoise shell markings. Some people also consider them calico, but you know, she's just swirled with everything you can think of as far as coloring, the white, the brown, and the black, and such a pretty, pretty cat. She's about a year old, and she was picked up as a stray from Bill Hart Road, no collar, no ID. And she is in C9. That is her cage number here at Animal Control. But what a beautiful girl she is, and she is so nice. Even the vet here at Animal Control said that this is a very nice cat. And we definitely agree that she is a nice cat and gorgeous too. Love, love, love her markings. So if you're interested in Hallie, she is down here at Animal Control, and she is definitely waiting for her forever home and for somebody very special to have the honor of being her new mom and dad. And now we have this precious girl with the nickname Holly, and Holly is so, so sweet, folks. She's still a puppy. She's about 8 months old, and she just loves to give kisses, too. She is just so affectionate and so wonderful. We just gave her a treat, and it took her a minute to realize that we wanted her to sit, but she did sit, so she does know some basic commands. And she's just an all-around wonderful dog. Yes, you are. They have her listed as a Jack Russell Terrier mix, and she is in B17. That is her cage number. Now, they did go ahead and test her for heartworms, and it came back negative. Now you get to get a good look at that pretty face. What a pretty girl she is. I love her markings and her little stripe, and she's even got this really funny underbite that we just absolutely love, where her bottom teeth kind of stick out a little further than the top, but it doesn't affect her eating or anything. It's just a wonderful little characteristic of this precious, precious girl. Looks like she was picked up as a stray from Glen Street, no collar, no ID, and oh, we just love her. She's even got a couple little freckles on that white muzzle of hers. So if you're interested in this girl, she's a really great dog, great size. She's not gonna get much bigger, you know, being 8 months old already, but just a really wonderful size. Not too big, not too small. Holly is just right. And we love Lola. This girl is such a nice, nice cat, folks. She is just extremely affectionate. And I know some of our loyal viewers out there that watch the show know that I always talk about the orange male tabbies. But this is a girl. This is a female orange tabby. And she is equally as affectionate as any male orange tabby would be. And actually, she's very rare because it's quite rare to find an orange tabby that's a female. And she has given me little love nibbles. That is not anything mean whatsoever, folks. When these cats get really excited, they just don't know what else to do but to just put your finger in their mouth. I mean, they just don't know what to do. They just get so excited, they give you little love nibbles. And she definitely is given lots and lots of love. She's got some long claws, though. She definitely needs a cat scratching post to be able to grind those claws down a little bit, but she is just wanting to be loved and give lots of love. Now Lola is in C12, that's her cage number here at Animal Control, and she was picked up as a stray from Gordon Road, no collar, no ID. She's still very, very young, only about a year old. Whoa, where are you going, Lola? And she just doesn't know what to do. She's got the air biscuits going on, she's checking out the room. She is just doing everything in her power to try to figure out what else she can love on for sure. She's just such a pretty girl. She's got the orange tabby, plus she has some white on her chest and on her paws. And we just absolutely adore this sweet cat. She really, really is so, so nice. So if you're interested in Lola, please come on down here and meet this girl. I think she wants to get down now and play or something. But come down and meet this girl. We know once you hold her and you spend some time with her, you are absolutely going to fall in love with Miss Lola. And folks, we have a really cute guy here now. This is Charlie. And you may think that he looks very much like another dog we had on not too long ago, and you would be right. Yes, he does look just like Stud that you might recall was on the show several weeks ago. But this is a different dog, believe it or not. I swear they are twins. This is Charlie. They have him marked as a beagle, but he's definitely not purebred beagle. He's got to be basset hound because he is just way too low to the ground and has those little short legs like the basset hounds do. So I would have to say he's probably a beagle basset hound mix, but just a really nice dog. He's about a year old and he is in B6. That is his kennel number. He was picked up as a stray from Marion Beavers Road. Now they do say that he's microchipped, so I don't know if they've been able to contact the owner, the previous owner or not, but I know that's something that Animal Control does do. If there's ID on the pet, they do contact the owners to see if they want to surrender the animal or if they want the animal back. So I don't know what his story is, but I hope it's not because he's heartworm positive. I do need to mention he is heartworm positive. I hope that's not why the owners might not be able to take him back, because truly it's not the end of the road for Charlie. Being heartworm positive, he can get treatment done at a local veterinarian. And I would even recommend trying the Help Spay Neuter Clinic to see if they could help you out with heartworm treatments or something for Charlie, because he really is a great, great dog. And like I said, it's not the end of the road when they have heartworms. It just means they just need a little extra help. So come on down and meet Charlie. I know that you're absolutely going to love this boy. Every time I look at him, he just makes me smile. Well, we had puppy love a minute ago. Now we have kitten love. And I was just saying, forget the monster mash. We're going to do the kitten mash. We love these little babies. They are just so stinking cute. Oh, and he's just talking to us also. I am holding little Frankie. I know, baby. And they are tiny, tiny little things. Oh my goodness. They're only maybe a couple of weeks old, maybe 4 weeks old. And little Frankie here is a black tabby with some white on him. And then we have his little sibling, Spooky, which is the little black and white kitty. And we're trying to come up with Halloween names. So Frankie is short for Frankenstein. And then we've got Spooky. And then we have the little sissy here on the end. That is Autumn. And all these little babies are so adorable. All these little siblings. And folks, they do not need to be here at Animal Control for very long. It is so, so hard for these little babies to thrive here at Animal Control. I'm going to put Frankie down by his siblings because he's just getting scared. There we go, buddy. There we go. So now Miss Suzanne has a lap full of kittens. So these are three little kittens that have lost their mittens, folks, and they don't know where those mittens are. They just need a new family. But oh goodness gracious, they are absolutely adorable. Such cute little babies. They're all in C19. That's their cage number here at Animal Control. And they were all picked up as a stray from Calico Loop. Go figure that we've got a cat name that is their street name that they were picked up. I have no idea where Calico Loop is, but they did not have any little collars on and no ID. So they are all lost little kittens that need a new family. And we just absolutely love them. They are just so precious and so sweet and so innocent. Folks, don't let these kittens grow up here at Animal Control. They need to be in a home as soon as possible. They will thrive so much better in a family environment where they can be held and be loved and not have to be in a cage. So come get one, come get two if you can. Squeeze in that third one and come get three, please. We would absolutely love to see these siblings stay together, two boys and a girl. They are just absolutely adorable. Again, we have Autumn, Spooky, and Frankie, and they are down here at Animal Control just waiting for you to rescue them. Folks, we have a true beauty queen here. This is Inez, and she is by far a purebred Siberian Husky. She's a black and cream, and oh, you've got to see these gorgeous blue eyes. Oh my goodness, she is so, so pretty. You gotta look up so people can see your ice blue eyes. I mean, ice, baby. That's all I got to say about those eyes. They are gorgeous. She's 3 years old and she's already been spayed, and somebody has absolutely got to be missing this girl because she was definitely somebody's pet. I mean, she's been spayed, she knows basic commands, she will not use the bathroom in her cage, she will actually cry until the workers here take her outside to use the bathroom outside because she absolutely will not use it in her cage. And so we know she's house trained. I mean, look at her, she's wonderful. She loves people, she's submissive enough to want a belly rub from a complete stranger. So, you know, she's just a great, great dog, and she is so pretty. She's in B20, that's her kennel number. She's heartworm negative. Oh my goodness, are you the perfect dog or what? I mean, Inez is just absolutely gorgeous. She was picked up as a stray from Corinth Road, and like I said, somebody's gotta be missing this girl because she is just too, too pretty and too, too special. And folks, if you love Siberian Huskies, you've gotta come down and meet this girl. Even if you don't love Siberian Huskies, you will love this girl. She is so smart, so pretty, and just a wonderful, wonderful dog. So come on down here and meet her. I know that when you look in her eyes, you are staring in the eyes of your new best friend. And folks, this is Stanley. And I tell you what, he is such a nice, nice cat. He's very, very nervous, which who can blame him? He hears those dogs barking back in the kennel area, and it's so loud. And you know, there's all these sights and smells and sounds that are just new to him and scary to him. So when you try to get him out of his cage, he will more than likely try to cower in the back corner and not come out. But you just have to get him out and hold him. He's so gentle and so sweet. And once he gets into a home environment where he's with a family and he feels safer and more secure, then he won't be so nervous and skittish and all of that. He'll definitely just settle in and just be a happy-go-lucky guy. But right now, he being here at Animal Control, he's just so nervous, as you can see, trying to snuggle and hide under Suzanne's arm because he really feels so secure being held by her. Now, he is in C37. That's his cage number. And it looks like Stanley is about a year old now, because when he came into Animal Control, he was about 10 months, and he's been here a couple of months, so we're looking at about a year old for this guy. So he's definitely fully grown, and oh, his little tail is curling up like a little monkey. It's just like a little circle. He's really, really very tense and very nervous, but he just needs to be in a home environment where he can feel safe and secure, and he will be absolutely fine. So come meet this gorgeous boy. I love his markings. He's the tabby. He's got stripes, but he's got these really neat, almost like dots, little spots all down his sides. And then, of course, his really pretty, clean, white face and white chest and some white on his paws. But a very handsome boy, a very sweet boy, and just very, very gentle. So come on down here and meet Stanley. I know that once you meet this guy and you hold him and make him feel secure, that he's just gonna love on you, and he has so much love to give. And folks, we hope that you can get a good look at this guy's face because it is absolutely cute. Let me see if I can get him to look up a little bit. He's just too interested in the treats that I might have hiding somewhere for him. But this boy we have nicknamed Hershey, and I tell you what, he is just absolutely adorable. He's just a cute little puppy. They're showing him as an American Pit Bull Terrier mix, and absolutely just stinking cute. I just can't say enough about this sweet boy. Had to name him Hershey because he has to have a sweet name for such a sweet little face. I love how his little brow kind of wrinkles when he's looking at things and he's so intent. Look at that. Now you got a good look at that cute face. What a cutie pie. Absolutely adorable. He's only about 4 months old, so he's still so young. But as you can see, there's such a difference in all the different dogs here. We've got the hyper dogs that are puppies. We've got the hyper dogs that are adult dogs. And then we have some of the puppies that are just a little bit more laid back, but definitely would be highly trainable. And you can teach them to catch a ball or play ball, play fetch with you. But just so, so cute. Hershey here is in B13. That's his cage number. And looks like he was picked up as a stray from Old Carrollton Road. No collar, no ID. And so he is just looking for a new home. And folks, you are not gonna regret adopting this boy. He is just absolutely cute and so, so sweet. And I could just stare at his sweet little precious baby face all day long. So come on down and meet Hershey. He definitely is sweet enough to give you a cavity. He's just that sweet. And folks, we have a very, very special boy. This is Tucker. And Tucker is a lab retriever mix, handsome boy, about 6 years old in B12. That's his kennel number. But we believe that he either is completely blind or partially blind. He just doesn't seem to be able to see things in front of him. He seems to bump into things and not even know that things are there, but he has great hearing and he definitely has a great sense of smell, but might possibly be completely blind. And so he needs somebody very special out there that understands a dog with a disability. And just because he can't see doesn't mean that he can't love. So you definitely need to remember that he is still a living, breathing creature that still needs a home no matter what. And we're not gonna let him be forgotten for sure. He's a very, very special boy that just needs to live the rest of his life with somebody that's very understanding and very loving and will take great care of him. So if you're interested in Tucker, he is in B12 here at Animal Control, and he is just a very special, very handsome boy, and just full of life and love. And so folks, that is our show for today. Thank you so much for joining us for our very special Halloween presentation. We hope that you enjoyed the show as much as we enjoy presenting it to you and showing you all these wonderful animals that are down here at Animal Control. And we just show you a smidgen of what is available here. You may have seen in the paper that they are really overcrowded here at Animal Control. They have not had to euthanize any animals in the past. I would say they didn't even have to put out a euthanasia list in the past 10 months until recently. And then all those animals were not euthanized. They ended up being rescued or adopted, so that's wonderful. But because they're so overcrowded, there may be another list coming out soon, and we definitely don't want to see that happen. We want to make sure all these fur babies and fur kids get a forever home. So thank you for watching. We want to make sure that we thank Coweta County Animal Control for allowing us to come down to your facility. Thank you to New Link for sending us Laura, our wonderful camera woman who keeps us on track and on time. And just the fact that New Link allows us to be on this network and provides us as a community to the, a service to the community to get to a chance to see all the wonderful animals that are up for adoption here at Animal Control. And also thank you to our wonderful volunteers who do so much to help these precious, precious souls to get a forever home. And if you want to find out more about what we're doing in the community, I think Tucker's going to be a big lap dog. You want to find out what Animal Control, or what Noonan Coweta Humane Society, rather, is doing in the community, please do visit our website at nchsrescue.org or come by Petco on Sundays. I believe we're there from about 12 to 4, but check our Facebook page because that will be a good resource for you to find out exactly when we're at Petco. And while you're at it, go ahead and like our Facebook page. You can get lots of information from our website and our Facebook page about volunteering, donating, and fostering. So we hope that you, again, we hope that you enjoyed the show today. We hope that you have a fabulous week and a very safe and happy Halloween. And we will see you next time on Adopt a Pet.